Happy Rusev Day, everyone. And what better way to celebrate Rusev Day than taking a look at the Bulgarian Brute and Roman Reigns? Now, we're also going to answer that question. I know a lot of you guys want to know, right? Is this Rusev? Do we have the ability to swap those legs to see if he's got full skin tone or if he has trunks just like this, right? Because, I mean, I did use those Triple H legs, but I was still really unhappy how loose it was. So I'm crossing my fingers, and I'm really hoping, because we haven't seen what's underneath those tights, right? So we want to see if we can get, like, the full-on trunks versus the shorts. So let's take a look at him, because I can't tell you. Well, let's take a look at the back. I can't tell you how excited I am to find out if that is actually the case, right? There he is, man. I'm telling you. Back then, he used to come out. He was, I gotta say, that character definitely did a lot for him, at least in the beginning. And not just in NXT, but also when they brought him over to the main roster. They made him look as this undefeated, like, monster, right? He was pretty much like a guy that would come out and squash whoever they put in the ring with. He would basically come out and squash everybody. And then he ended up cutting his hair. And this is a true story. So, his hair got pretty long. I mean, in the beginning, it was short. But his hair got nice and long. And Vince McMahon, he was loving it. I mean, he really liked the style of it. And then next thing you know, he cut his hair. He cut his hair. And he didn't tell WWE. He didn't tell Vinny. And he got upset. Vinny got upset. And if you're wondering why he hasn't gotten the push, regardless of how over he's gotten with the crowd, that's the reason why. That's basically the truth behind it. Oh, that's cool. So back here, it shows, it says, what, Bulgaria? So it looks, the outline work around it, it's pretty much showing, like, the, I think it's the outline of Bulgaria, right, of the country. So right there, debut, 5/30/2013. That's pretty close to my birthday, man. That's pretty cool. So this man came along right around the same time I was celebrating to be, how old is Hero Fix? We all wanted to know, right? We all know he's an adult, still playing with figures. He does come with a piece of wood. This is cool. See, when I bought Hacksaw Jim Duggan, I bought him loose. Mine didn't come with a piece of wood. I'm pretty sure that one had more like sculpt, like actual line work. This one doesn't. It is breakaway. We gotta test it on Rusev. We gotta see how effective this weapon is, right? Accessory. Not weapon, but accessory. YouTube monetizing. Here it is. Let's bash it over his head. Oh, that's pretty cool. That's awesome. So the head skin right there, young Rusev. Look at that. There is young Rusev back in the day when he was a brute. Now it's him and Aiden English, right, coming out and singing. Yeah, he's singing. You guys got to check out that music video that he did. That had me dying. I don't know how many views it got on YouTube, but I'm pretty sure you guys have already seen it. If you haven't, Google it, search it. Right there, it says Bulgaria. Tattoo on the back is also there. That's one thing I really enjoyed about the back tattoo on Rusev was that it continued. It continued even when you had him going forward. I mean, it stops like you really have to push it forward until it finally stops. But I mean, if you're putting him in, like, you know, the submission hold and you pulling back on that neck on your opponent, that's cool, man. I really like that. This is, okay, so part of this is an entrance rope. I don't know if you call it a rope. You could call it more of like a, I don't know if skirt is also the right word, but I'm pretty sure it unbuttoned. Yes, it does. So it looks like it's held together by the button. So we take that off, and now for the moment of truth. We need drum roll, right? We need a drum roll. Is it? It is. That's awesome. So we're definitely doing a, oh, that is disappointing though. Check this out, you guys. So it is skin tone. It is skin tone, but I'm going to try to shove this up higher so you guys can see it. Because I think once you take this off, it ain't coming off. All right. So it is skin tone, but thing of it is what they did is that they just painted over it. Look at that. So it's still the shorts, but it's skin tone shorts. So it's going to look really, really iffy once you actually swap it on. Still going to do it just to see. We'll do it on an updated video for sure, on a custom fix-up video. But you see how they just paint? That's terrible. Come on. Like, how difficult or how much could it possibly have cost just to make, like, new sculpt on that? Nope, they didn't. They just said, let's paint over it. Let's do it skin tone. It's not like people are going to actually swap the legs, right? Or maybe they did that on purpose. Maybe they did that on purpose so when his next leak comes out, people don't stop themselves from buying it. Like, oh, well, they already got the updated legs. Let's take a look at Roman. That is, I'm disappointed. That was like 95. It's definitely a high percentage of the reason why I bought that figure. Here's Roman. Here is young Roman before he got all shield up, right? This guy, when he first came out, come to think of it, actually, I think he was heel. And they should have stuck with that because, I mean, they really tried to shove Roman down our throats as a face, but people just, Even, I mean, like, when he was with Shield, I'll tell you what, he definitely got over with the crowd. But once Dean Ambrose got injured again, man, they can't. I mean, I think he's, in my opinion, he's definitely put in his work. You know, whether or not he's up there to, like, challenging for the Universal title, you know, that's a question I'll leave up to you guys. So, here it is. Now, the one thing that I did notice right off the bat when we unboxed this, when we did the unboxing video, was how the head scan was sitting really, really funny on it. Cloth shirt. We're getting an NXT shirt. Let's put on the shirt right now. Was how just strange and not right the head scan was looking on it. I think it was five or six different head scans we've gotten with Roman now, and there was one that I just really could not stand, but I think this one is definitely taking the cake on that for sure. The shirt right there, I'm happy that we did get this. You can actually use this shirt on a lot of different characters. I mean, if you're doing promos with, whether it's Bobby Roode, you know, or just, you know, like our current champion, like, you can put the shirt on a lot of different characters, so that's cool. They didn't make it exclusive to Roman. I mean, they could have easily put in, like, a Roman logo somewhere, but no, you can throw it. It's not fitting on there. Maybe it's because of his guns. I think it's because of the guns. You gotta kind of slide it up, and will we get it snapped on there? Let's find out. Will it? It'll snap on the back. There you go. Will it snap on the bottom? I don't think so. We'll snap it towards the middle. Middle, we got the middle. Yeah, we got the middle right. So there it is. There's the NXT shirt. Pretty sick. I don't recall another. Maybe the Nexus. I think the Nexus might have had a similar shirt. I never picked up those basic figures, so I really can't tell you whether or not we've got. I'm pretty sure this is new. Can almost guarantee that this is, like, at least the logo, how it's sitting on the shirt. Let's take off the shirt. Now, here's the thing. Young Roman, he did not have the tattoo, like, all out, like, the way that he does it now. So if you're wondering, like, hey, man, they didn't finish the rest of the tattoo like they did in Elite Series 56. This is actually how he had his tattoo when he was younger. It wasn't, like, more towards the center or, like, if you look at his tattoo now, it's definitely, he's added more to it, right? But there it is. And here's the thing, too. I'm really happy that they didn't do the shortcut, because just about every Elite we've gotten with Roman, they stop. They stop the tattoo work, like, let's say, 3/4 of the way before it gets underneath the socket. So they did actually went all out on that, which is good, because, man, I can't tell you. You could almost even swap this. No, because I believe there's more tattoo added on inside the armpit. Right here, this almost looks like a horseshoe to me. I don't think it's a horseshoe. I didn't watch Roman back in NXT days, so someone drop it in the comment section. What is that? Doesn't it look like a horseshoe to you? Maybe it's like his logo design. I know on the back right here, this is definitely a horse. It's got to be a horseshoe. Come on. I mean, if he's got a horse on the back, it's got to be a horseshoe. So there's, and I think so same torso we've gotten in the previous Elites. The legs right here, not much to it. Just getting your standard black long knee pads. The boots, they are slightly different. On the tip right there, it's got like a nice little red outline tip. Almost kind of like, I know these are not cowboy boots, but I think that's kind of what he was going for. So pretty cool figure. I got to say, I am happy with it. I'm definitely doing a head swap. Definitely not liking the head scan on this. This is just maybe because of how they just, like, the peg that they ended up going with, how it sits low. But it just looks weird. Like, the man got, like, hit over. Where's that piece of wood? The man got hit with that piece of wood. It's somewhere around here. And the man did not recover from it. Like, it never came back up, right? And that Rusev, jeez, I can't tell you why. Okay. Gonna give it a solid 7. Rusev. The overall figure, I gotta say it's a solid 8, but I'm telling you, the reason why I wanted this was to swap those legs, but you can't. I mean, you can. It's gonna look weird, but you guys will see it. We'll definitely, I'll keep you guys updated on that. Until next time, everybody.